Butterfly Beauty. This is a bold lip special event inspired makeup look. The complexion and the eyes are very neutral in tone, so it'll complement any bold lip you choose to wear with it. I chose this warm raspberry lip because it screams summer to me. I also use the new Anastasia Modern Renaissance Eye Palette. I have to say, it's probably my favorite palette I've ever used. The pigmentation and quality of the eyeshadows are amazing. And I'm going to include the time right here. If you want to fast forward this video and just see the swatches on my fair skin, I wanted to do swatches because I find that it's hard sometimes if you have as light a skin as I do to really get an accurate picture of how products are gonna look on your skin tone. So with that, let's get into this look. To prime the skin for foundation, I'm gonna be first using the OSEA Atmosphere Protection Cream. I've been really liking this for an added moisture boost prior to foundation, and I really like the way my foundation sits on top of it. As a base for that ultimate glamorous summer glow, I'm gonna be mixing together the Becca Backlight Primer and Becca's Shimmering Skin Perfector in Moonstone, the liquid. I just take one pump of each on the back of my hand. I've been really liking the Estee Lauder Double Wear for its staying power and its full coverage. So how I like to apply it is I'm first going to apply one layer all over the skin, and using the Morphe 439 buffing brush, I'm going to use a downwards motion to blend it into the skin. And then once it's dry, I look to see where I need that extra coverage, and I'll use a stippling type motion to build up that coverage. Start adding structure and build the foundation for our contour. I'm going to be using the Becca Low Light Primer and this angled stippling brush from Makeup Geek. And I'm stippling it on the highest point of the hollow of my cheekbone and bringing it down to the corner of the outer V of my eye. Now I'm going to be stippling this by my temples and the top portion in the center of my forehead. Now to highlight the center portion of my face, I'm going to be using the MAC Prolongwear Concealer, blending it out with my Damn Beauty Blender. Under my eyes, I'm going to be stippling the concealer into those areas with the Morphe G2 brush. I'm immediately going to set my under eye area with the MAC Pro Emphasize Shaping Powder. I'm also going to be priming the eyes for shadow with that same concealer, and then setting that with what's left over on my Real Techniques brush. It's to set my foundation and make sure that it creases as little as possible throughout the day, I'm going to be using a velour powder puff and the RMS Translucent Powder, and I'm going to be pressing it into the skin. Okay, so let's get into the swatches. Going top to bottom row, left to right, we have Tempura, Golden Ochre, Vermeer, Juan Fresco, Antique Bronze, Love Letter, and Cypress Umber. Bottom row, we have Raw Sienna, Burnt Orange, Primavera, Red Ochre, Venetian Red, Warm Taupe, and Real Gar. To begin, I'm taking Tempura on a medium angled shader brush and I'm highlighting my brow bone. Next, on a shadow brush, I'm taking Primavera and I'm tapping it across my entire lid area. As a transition shade, I'm applying Golden Ochre to the upper portion of my crease. Then to connect my lower lash line to my upper lash line, I'm smudging Warm Taupe. Then taking Warm Taupe, I'm applying it to the outer V of my eye, diffusing it up into the crease in order to start building dimension in that outer V area. And then I'm applying Antique Bronze to the outer V of my eye, and using a diffuse crease brush from Sigma, I'm blending that out, diffusing it into the lower crease area, and I will be doing this process a couple times to really build up that dimension. Then I'm lightly applying Cypress Umber to the most outer edge of the outer V of my eye, and then taking Primavera again to really blend out the lid, add that pigmentation, and ensure that there are no harsh lines. I'm re-highlighting my brow bone again with Tempura, and then using a small angled brush, I'm lining the outer third of my eye with Cypress Umber. And then using Vermeer to highlight the inner corner of my eye. And then I'm taking a little burnt orange and diffusing it through the upper crease area as well as the lower lash line in order to blend that out. I thought this eye look definitely called for a wing liner, and I used the Maybelline Waterproof Black Gel Liner. And then on my waterline, I used the Waterproof Brown New liner for Makeup Forever, which is awesome. I ended up applying my false lashes off camera, but I'm prepping them here, and I use the House of Lashes Siren. Now with this Real Techniques Dual Fiber Contour Brush, I'm going to be taking the Kevyn Aucoin Sculpting Powder in Medium, and I'm going to be contouring my cheekbones. Next, with the Sweetheart Bronzer by Too Faced and this It Cosmetics Heavenly Luxe Radiance Wand, I'm going to be blending out that contour powder and bronzing up the portions of my face that would naturally get a tan, so in that three-type shape. Now for the ultimate glamorous summer glow, I'm going to be using this Sigma Duo Fiber Blush Brush. This really allows you to buff the highlighter into the skin. Now I'm going to be using this contour duo from Nars in the shade Olympia. It's technically a contour shade. I love it for blush. It's very neutral in tone, and you can pair it with any lip color. Next, I'm going to be setting my makeup in place with the Skindinavia Bridal Makeup Setting Spray. I spray two times in an X and two times in a T. and one for good luck. So really, you can pair any bold lip with this look. A red would be beautiful. I'm going to be using Catherine by Anastasia, which is a raspberry shade with brown undertones. And so it's a more neutral, bold lip option for going to a special event like a wedding.
Thank you so much for watching. All products used will be listed in the description bar down below. I will see you in my next one. You're beautiful inside and out.